Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum, my dear student. How are you? I hope you will fine. I am your science teacher from Ismailia Youth Services School. And today, now the topic is the human body. I have some terms. You are observing this slide. There are the some terms which are defined. I will define them one by one. Now, first one, cell. Cell are the simplest body units of living things. There are the different types of cell in our body, just like our blood cells, bone cells, which you be already defined you. Now, second one, the term is tissue. A tissue is a special group of cells. Now, third one, organ. Organ, the group of tissue which perform a similar job is called an organ. Do you know about the organ? Have you studied in your previous classes the senses organ? Just like eyes, nose, tongue, ear, and our skin. These are the senses organ which are make our life better. The senses organs I have in our body, they do their work automatically without taking the instruction. Okay, same here, I have so many other organs. The organs work to the group of the other organs and make the organ system, just like a circulatory system, breathing system, nervous system. So there are so many systems which make a human body. Now we have the tissues. Tissues are the ligament and tendon. Tendon and ligament both are the tissue. Ligament join bone to bone. And tendon, ligament join bone to bone. Okay? And tendon. Tendon join, tendon is also a tissue and it joins muscles to bone. Now, there are the joints. The skeleton consists of the joint. There are the different type of joint, just like a ball and socket joint. And hinge joints are here. Ball and socket joint, just like they are move in all direction. Ball and socket, okay, move in all direction. And hinge joint move in a only one direction. Ball and socket joint move in all direction. When you go to the swimming pool, so you use your shoulder joint to move in a water. Easily you can swim in water by using your shoulder joint. These joints are called a ball and socket because it's move in a circular form. Okay, when in a cricket, the bowler throw the ball, they use their ball and socket joint, means shoulder joint, and throw the ball for the batsman. Now, hinge joint move in a one direction. One direction means just like when we lift the weight, so we use our elbow joint, okay? And knee joint, when we hit the football, we use our knee joint. These are the types of joint which in our syllabus. Ball and socket joint and hinge joint. Ball and socket move in all direction and hinge joint move only in one direction. Okay, now there are the two types of bone, stirrup and femur. Stirrup is the smallest bone which is present inside the middle ear. Stirrup is the smallest bone which is present in our middle ear. Do you know our ear divide into three parts, outer ear, middle ear and inner ear. But in a middle ear, there are three types of little bones. First one, hamel, animal, stirrup. But stirrup is the so smallest bone in our body. Okay, and femur, it is present in our leg. Femur is a strongest and longest bone in our body, because our whole body rests on two femurs, rest on these two femurs bone. So these bones are longest and strongest bone in our body. Now the skeleton. The skeleton is very important for us because we can move. It protects our internal organs of the body, just like it protects our internal organ, heart and lungs, protect by the ribs. Okay, and the hollow bone inside our body is a factory of the blood cells, where the red cells and white cells produce. Okay, and calcium also stored in our skeleton. Okay, these terms are very important in this unit. Now the skeletal system is a very important system, but it cannot do the work alone. Okay, it's need to the support. Now muscular system. Muscular system, are you seeing the slide of the muscular system? Yes. Okay, these are the muscles. Okay, muscles, muscular system, it support the skeleton. When the skeleton system and muscular system combine together, and they make a musculoskeletal system. First of all, we discuss here, what are the muscles? Muscle is a tissue consisting of sheet or bundles of cells. Okay, muscles is a tissue consisting of sheets or a bundle of cells. Muscles are capable of contracting to produce movement or tension. Capable means able. Okay, muscles are able to contracting to produce the movement or tension. Now, the muscular system. Muscular system made up of the muscles and tendon. Tendon, we have already discussed with you, but now I repeat the tendon. Tendon is a tissue which join muscles to bone. Okay, tendon is a tissue which join the muscles with bone. You can observe there are the some joints are here in this picture. You can observe these are the joints, here are the joints, these are the joints. Okay, there are so many joints which are joined by the tendon. Okay, some joints can move and some joints cannot move. Just like our skull have the joint, but they cannot move. Our jawbone is a joint, but it can move when we eat the food. So it's move our jaw. Okay, so this is the knee joint, elbow joint and knee joint. It is move. Okay, some joints can move and some joints cannot move. Now in the muscular system, the muscular system consisting of muscles and tendons that are capable of contracting to produce movement or tension. Okay, now the types of the muscles. There are the three types of muscles. Number one, the skeletal muscles, cardiac muscles, and smooth muscles. First one, the cardiac muscle. First one, skeletal muscles. Skeletal muscles are our voluntary muscles. Okay, these are the voluntary muscles make the movement possible. Okay, skeletal muscles join to bone with the help of the tendon muscles. Muscles in the skeletal muscles, the skeletal muscles, you can observe the muscle joined with the bones by the help of the tendon. Okay, tendon is a tissue which join the bone and muscles. Okay, skeletal muscles are joined with the bones with the help of the tendon. Okay, now there are the different types of muscles. Now second one is the cardiac muscles. Cardiac means heart. Okay, when we go to the hospital, so we observe there are the different types of the ward, just like cardiac ward, kidney ward, neuro wards. So the cardiac ward, the heart patient are admitted in the cardiac ward. Now the cardiac muscles are those muscles, they do their work automatically. The cardiac muscles make our heart. The cardiac muscles make our heart. Cardiac muscles contract to pump the blood out and then relax to back in after it circulated throughout the body. Okay, cardiac muscles, cardiac means our heart, and heart's wall made by the cardiac muscles. Cardiac muscles are involuntary muscles. Involuntary means they do their work automatically. We cannot control it. Okay, it's not need our instruction. They do their work automatically. The heart is a very powerful organ inside our body. It do their work continuously. It's a very powerful organ. Heart work with the other arteries, vein and capillaries and lungs, and do the their work or make a system. This system is called a circulatory system. In a cardiac muscles, our heart is made by the cardiac muscles. Cardiac muscles contract and relax. Contract means suparna, relax means phailna. Okay, now smooth heart muscles are the smooth muscles. Smooth muscles are make our hollow organs. Smooth muscles make our hollow organs, make the stomach, intestine, bladder, and so on. Smooth muscles are hollow organs. Our stomach wall are made by the smooth muscles. They do their work automatically. Okay, they are involuntary muscles. It's mean they do their work automatically. They not need to our instruction. Okay, for example, when we eat the food, it passes into our stomach through the food pipe. Okay, and our stomach is just like a pouch. There is a space inside our stomach. It's just like a pouch. It stores our food and it is hollow inside. Okay, so the food is stored inside the stomach. Stomach wall are made by the smooth muscles. There are the different types of organ which are hollow organs which are made by the smooth muscle, just like our intestine, small intestine, large intestine, bladder, and our stomach. These are the example of the smooth muscles. Okay, now the three types of the muscles. First one, the skeletal muscles, cardiac muscles, and smooth muscles. Skeletal muscles are joined with the bones, the help of the tendon. You can observe the muscles joined with the bones with the help of the tendon. In a cardiac muscles, they are involuntary muscles. These muscles contract to pump the blood out and then relax to back in after it circulated throughout the body. You can observe there is an organ of heart, and it's work with the help of their blood capillaries, vein and arteries, and lungs also are here. They help and make us our circulatory system. The heart is for the cardiac muscles. These walls are made by the cardiac muscles. The wall of the heart made by the cardiac muscles. Third one, smooth muscle. Smooth muscles, you can observe, there is a picture of the smooth muscles. Okay, these all organs are hollow organs. Okay, now we discuss here the what are the voluntary and involuntary. Okay, first we differentiate these two terms which are new for you. Is skeletal muscles are also called the voluntary muscles. Listen carefully. Skeletal muscles are also called voluntary muscles. This means that they move when we want them to move. Okay? If you want to run, so we can run. If you want to sit, so we can sit. If you want to walk, so we can walk. It depends on our will, on our desire. Okay? We can control, okay? We can control our skeletal muscles. These are the voluntary muscles. So voluntary muscles we can control. What they do? Skeletal muscles are joined with the bones with the help of the tendon. For example, all skeletal muscles are voluntary muscles. It means they depend on our desire, on our will. When we want to move, so they can move. Okay, voluntary muscles depend on our instruction. Voluntary muscles, skeletal muscles are also called voluntary muscles. This means that they move when we want them to move. We can control what they do. Skeletal muscles are joined with the bones with the help of the tendon. Tendon is a tissue which joins the muscles to the bone. Okay, and for example, all skeletal muscles which join the muscles to bone are called are example of the voluntary muscles. Now, next one, involuntary muscles. Involuntary muscles perform their job without you even thinking about it. It means not need your instruction. They keep doing their work automatically. Stomach, smooth muscles and cardiac muscles. Both are involuntary muscles. It means when we take the food, it is stored in our stomach. So if we give the instruction that digest our food stomach, so they can digest. No, it's not need for our instruction. They can do their work automatically. They are not controlled by me or us, okay? They can do their work by their requirement, okay? When we are going, when we are sleeping, when we are watching, but they do their work. Mean stomach digests their food when we do anything, but without instruction, they do their work. These muscles are for the involuntary muscles, okay? Involuntary muscles, we cannot control them. They do their work automatically. And voluntary muscles are controlled by me or us. You can control your voluntary muscles and you cannot control your involuntary muscles. Voluntary muscles are depend on our desire, on our instruction, and involuntary muscles not need to our instruction or desire or will. They do their work automatically. Okay. Now, what can go wrong with bones? What can go wrong with bones? Bones can bend or break easily in older people. Bones can break or fracture because of the injury. Okay? Now, by the any accident and damage of our bone, okay, so we should do the work carefully and protect our bones. Same, muscles can be weak and joint can be damaged by the injury, by the accident, or by any disease. And when the people grow older, their bones can be bent. Okay, you can observe this picture. The old man has bent their bone. and the boy has the fracture of their bone. So bones can be damaged, okay, by the fracture, by the injury, or by any disease. So we should, how can we keep our bones strong? If we want to keep our bones strong, we should take the calcium rich food. Good sources of the calcium we should take, just like a milk, yogurt, fortified orange juices, fortified cereal dalia, and cheese, and so many things which they have in all dairy products have a calcium. So we should take the calcium, and vitamin D we also get from the sun rays, so we should take the sunlight. Okay, that is very important for our bones. We can keep our bones strong if we take the calcium rich food. Okay, now. Okay, now keeping our bones strong, good sources of the calcium, fortified orange juice, yogurt, milk, cheese, and cereal. These all things have the calcium, and vitamin D also we can get from the sunlight. These all things, vitamin D and calcium rich food, we can get from the dairy product, which are important for our bones. So we should keep our bones strong if we take the calcium rich food and sunrise, which has a vitamin D. Both things are important for our bones. You should take the daily milk. Okay, that's very important for your bones. Okay, enough. Athletes and motorcyclists. Student, you can take the screenshot of this slide. Okay, athletes and motorcyclists use the safety equipments. Bones, everyone know about the bones. Bones are very important. So how can we protect our bones? We can protect our bone if we take the calcium rich food and vitamin D. And when the athletes and player and motorcyclist do their work, so they use the safety equipments that are very important for their bones. Just like they use the neck pad, knee pad, helmet, gloves, special shoes, and elbow pad, and etc. Just like here is a picture of the some equipments which use the athletes and motorcyclists. Helmet is very important for the motorcyclist. Athletes mean a person trained to compete in a sport. Okay, now a person trained to compete in a sport means taking a participate in the different sports. They are called the athletes. And motorcyclists use also the safety equipments to protect their bones, just like a special shoes they wear, gloves, and helmet, which is very important for the motorcyclist, and knee pads, gloves, and teeth covered, also important for the athletes and player. They use these all things to protect their bones. Okay, so now these all equipments are very important for you. So you should, when you play the game, so carefully use the some safety equipments you can use if you have, so you can use. And especially when you sit on the motorcycle, and when your brother and elder ride on the bike, they use these safety equipments, because helmet is also very important for the motorcyclists. So they protect their bones. Now the conclusion. Today we have discussed the muscles and their types. Their types means the muscles have three types: smooth muscles, cardiac muscles, and skeletal muscles. We have discussed all these. Okay, now the importance of the bone. How can we keep our bones strong? How can we keep? We have already discussed these things, which thing we will use, and we can take the calcium rich food and vitamin D from the sunlight so we can keep our bones strong. Safety equipments we should use. Okay, the athletes and sportsmen use the safety equipments that are important for their bones. They can protect their bones from any injury, okay, an accident and any hit, bumps. Now, the home task is here. Okay, listen, you can take the screenshot of this screen, yes? Write a short note. I have given you the mind map yesterday. So I have mentioned here, how will you make a mind map in your copy? You can take the screenshot of this picture, this slide. Write a short note on bones, at least 5 points. See the picture. See the book page number 4 and 5. Okay, from the book page number and 5, you can take the help for this answer. You can write the 4 and 5 lines for the bones. Now, second, make a mind map on a skeletal system. Page number 4, there is a skeletal system picture, and first you write the inner center, the skeletal system, then you write the name of the bones, skull, spine, ribs and femur, and then you will write the skull protect our delicate brain, spine protect inner soft organ. Okay, in this way you make the 8 points. 4 points are here: skull, spine, rib and femur. And then you will write what do the skull do. Skull protect our delicate brain. You will write here. In here, either there, if there is a rib, so you can write here, rib protect inner soft organ, heart and lungs. Femur. Femur is a bone. It is the longest bone in our body. Ribs, spine, support, head and neck. Okay? These 8 points you will make in your copy. This mind map you will draw in your copy and write 8 points on it. Okay? There are the question on the front. Yes, you can see there is a question, and on the front of this question there is the answer number, page number 4. So page number 4 have the answer of the function of the skeleton. Okay, and question number 2, take a screenshot. Okay, good. Now, what is the joint? Which two types of the question number 2, what is the joint and which two types of the joints have been discussed in this unit? Where is each of them found in the body? So you can take the help from page number 5. Okay. And this also you can complete. Question number 3. Answer is on book page number 6. Okay. For question number, its answer you can check on book page number 6. And last one, the 5 suggestion and any two ways to take good care of your muscles and bones, so you can take the help from book page number 7. There are the 3 activity, number 1 and number 2 activity you will not perform because these are the classroom activity, but activity number 3 you will do. Now this is the 3 activity. Okay, take this screenshot of this. This is the activity 3. Find out what safety equipments is used motorcyclists and athletes to safeguard their bones. See slide 8. Okay. Pre-reading task. Read the unit Animal Kingdom and underline the difficult words. Indicate the important points of the pre-reading task. Okay. Next time you will learn about the new topic you will learn. Okay. Now you will learn about the teeth. Okay.